Hi, I'm John Whitbeck, partner at Whitbeck, Cisneros, McElroy, and today I want to talk to you briefly about mental health issues in Virginia. You know, one thing I've learned as a former professor of mental illness law and director of the George Mason Mental Illness Clinic, and of all the countless cases I've done, Virginia law is just totally inadequate to care for the majority of the mentally ill across the Commonwealth. So what we've got to do is develop strategies for helping you get mental health treatment for your loved ones, family members, or friends. And so one of the things we like to do is come up with, within the framework of the law as it does exist, is strategies for getting that done. And we've used a lot of things like guardianships and conservatorships in mental health cases. And you know, a guardianship is typically for individuals who are elderly, who are suffering from dementia, or we want to make sure that we're taking care of them because they can't make decisions for themselves. And conservatorships is the same thing, taking care of people's property. But we've developed strategies along the lines of guardianships and conservatorships to help individuals out there who are trying to get treatment for loved ones. Now, guardianships and conservatorships are not perfect. They don't get you everything you want to go. But there are ways to use that to gain more access to information, to make sure that you can commit a person for up to 10 days in certain circumstances. Use a guardianship process as a means of making medical decisions that may not be related to psychiatric treatment that may help you get there eventually. But all in all, it's the best tool available that we found in the civil realm to help you with the strategy to get mental health treatment for someone that you're concerned about. So give us a call. We can talk to you about your particular case, talk to you about a particular strategy. We can talk to you how we've in the past used guardianships and conservatorships for just that. So I'm looking forward to speaking with you.